chilly this morning. 12 degrees below zero on the drive out, but it's about 8 degrees, 7 degrees below zero right now. I just got back and Todd got a campfire started. He's trying to get his heater working, but it's a diesel-fueled one of those construction heaters, and the fuel's too cold. So this is it. It's the last big push, the last big day outside. This is the last big day that I have Todd, because he's got a bunch of stuff, like I said earlier, he's got to get done on his own. So our plan is to put windows in and wrap the outside of this house. And then everything happens after that is going to be pretty much indoors. I still have to build that porch yet, and I put a staircase on there, but I think I'm going to wait for the staircase until spring, when I know the ground's not going to go anywhere. But I'll make sure to get something in there temporarily. But yeah, get busy today. And I'm using the old microphone because the other one's just a pain in the neck with the wiring and everything else right now. I'll use that when I get back inside again. Struggling over there to get that thing heated up.
gonna tie it on my side or your side? Let's go tie it on your side so that.
A little old, is it?
Wait, three trips up and down there, okay. I got it, I have an extra fuel.
Something that somewhere else would be an easy task. Yeah, you know,
yeah, I would
have been smarter.
But there's no starting point, so
I started to put it on the house. That would have been smarter. Where's the drawing at? I know, right?
It'd be easier to lift it on that.
Tarp. Yeah, I don't know where the. How far?
little bit of ground with it.
Spideys. Bottom, huh?
Yep, it's good.
You have a bottom.
Okay. Maybe the screw and the...
Huh? Oh, we need the screws and the screw gun, right? Probably should hit this with a torch first to thaw it out a little bit.
Is it nailed shut or just frozen shut?
I think it's frozen shut. But I don't remember putting any nails in it.
I would say at least grab your screw gun so we can get one screw in it, and then we can kind of try and thaw it out. I'd put it in while it's still frozen.
Yeah.
Not like we're not fighting with the door. Oh. You got a hole.
I just don't know if, we should measure this first or just go for it?
Yeah. You got a tape if you want. So did you buy this one new?
No, I actually came from the guy that I borrowed the scaffolding from.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, the guy that I borrowed the scaffolding from, his name's Tom.
You have to call this.
Depending on how far it goes. Anyway, his name's Tom, and he had
37 and 3/8.
He had this door inside, and he wanted to get rid of it.
38, he had 20.
Okay, what about top to bottom? That's the big one that I'm worried about.
82 1/4.
Yeah, so Tom had this in his house, and he pulled it out and put in a regular 2x4 door.
81 1/2. 20.
Oh, my gosh.
I would shim the top of those, put a piece of 5/8 plywood on top.
Right.
Rather than have that huge gap there.
Oh, no, yeah.
Yeah.
Because I've got all those strips anyway.
And then you can use, you know, 1.5 molding around it or something and take up that gap so you don't...
Right, and then I've got all kinds of small pieces I could use to shim that up with anyway, so. We're about to put the door on this cabin.
Man, you got friggin' about 8 million spiders living underneath this thing.
That's all right. Spiders are friggin' wonderful. They eat mosquitoes. Everything that eats mosquitoes is wonderful.
No.
You don't like spiders?
Fucking spiders and snakes have no place in my world.
You're Jim Stafford. You don't like spiders and snakes, and that ain't what it takes.
No.
No way.
Okay. Yeah, we got to thaw that ice. That's up against the ice.
That's pretty awesome though, man.
There's a screw in there.
I don't know where. Usually we've got a plug right there, but then I see one.
Okay.
Solid
ice. We got to pull it down anyway because we got to do the ice drill, right?
Yeah.
Thank you. screwdriver so often that now I just buy the pack when they're on sale at the orange store. One day I'm going to clean something and I'm going to find like 80 screwdrivers.
You would think, but it doesn't seem to happen.
They're like the sock, right? You, when you do your laundry and you're all, I know I had these two socks in here. Where'd the other one go? Alternate universe.
I tell the gal that when I take my laundry in, I said, don't worry, the socks that don't match. She goes, okay, thanks for telling me.
Is that the only one we had in there?
I thought there might be one down here, but here.
There you go. Ready?
There's Cappy.
There we go. That was it. Okay, shall we now? Tack it in through side, or?
Huh?
You said tack it in through here?
You can, or you can go through the molding to the plywood. That screw might not be long enough.
Yeah, I might need longer screws for that.
Yeah. It's pretty thick molding.
I'll do it over there.
I'll have to get the level up and level it to the top, and then you can stick the screw in the top.
Much screw in there.
I think you'd be better off going. I don't know how big the gap is behind there. You go up here.
Go where?
Over here. If you can, have a smoking shelf. And then use finish nails out here.
Cutter two. Thank you.
It's not really that cold. I'm just still fighting whatever this fever is that I've got. So let me show you what I got here for the tyvek. Let me get back so you can get a better view of it. There we go, all the way up the back here. I do need to put some more staples in. But I was getting to a point where I couldn't really do much more between using the ladder here and the scaffolding. So I'm going to move. I'll keep the scaffolding here until I finish stapling off the lower half of that. And then I'll move everything around to the front so that I can do the front part. But the whole thing is wrapped except for there's a strip right at the top. See if I can get in here so you can see it. Right, there's a strip right up there at the top that I need to go ahead and do, but I'm not going to do that until after I do the front part here. That's going to do it for now on this tyvek. Again, I got to staple off a bunch in here too. I'm going to head back in here, close up the door, and start doing more insulation hanging, and I'm going to hang every bay that I possibly can today. Kicking my butt, man. I have no idea what it is that got me, but I walked into work today to pick up some ingredients for dinner because I really was jonesing for shepherd's pie again. And when I walked in, they said, dude, like six people called in sick today. So whatever it is, it's running through the store fast and furious. It's pretty out today, though, too. It's about 18, maybe 20 degrees, and it's gorgeous. We got snow coming in. It's going to be a beautiful, beautiful week. Thank you.